I'm going to be really honest with that. You know, I'm disappointed with Arteta.
Where's your Arsenal hat today, by the way, Lee?
They got absolutely bullied by Erling Haaland. It's Didier Drogba all over again.
Hello and welcome back to Last Man Standing. My name is Flav. On the show this week, we've got Adam McKola, we've got Buvey, and we've got Lee Judges, and we're looking at the fallout from the Arsenal versus Manchester City game. What does it mean for the title race? Where will that title be ending up? Have the wheels fallen off at Arsenal? Haaland's just a bit good, isn't he? If you're new to Last Fan Standing, hit like and subscribe. Get involved in the comments below. And let's go on with it. So, I mean, there's only one place to start, and that's probably with you, Lee. Have you, you know, heard that song, "The wheels on the bus are falling off, aren't they, Lee?"
No, I've not heard that. Like,
that's terrible.
Because I'm not a kid. I'm not a kid no more. Like, you know what I mean? Like, yeah.
I mean, like, I've not got a dog in a fight. I should remain impartial. But Lee, what's going on? Because you've got 1 point from nine. This was a big, big moment. You didn't beat Manchester City.
Always going to happen, Flav. Always going to happen. Listen, it's all doom and gloom for Arsenal at the moment. Isn't it? Level on points with Man City with a game in hand. 5 points clear with Man United with a game in hand. Get this one. 12 points clear of Tottenham with a game in hand. It's not all doom and gloom. Look, we was actually beaten yesterday by, Man City are very, very good. So you can't give Man City chances like we did yesterday. You can't do that, like, you know. And the one difference in the two teams yesterday is that when it comes to punishing for mistakes or punishing goals, they took their chances really well, and you have to give them credit for that. The boy and the goal, we made that look easy. It wasn't, but, you know, and then the second goal was a good move after we give them the ball away. Listen, we're not in a good form at the moment. Big, big blow yesterday was losing Thomas Partey just before the game, but unfortunately, he's got a history of that, and we just got to dust ourselves down. What's the most important thing now is to get back to winning ways as quickly as possible, and we've got to do that now against Villa. Villa, we have to win that game.
Some might say, and it's not me, right? I've got to ask the difficult questions for you.
Yeah, go far away. I'm ready for them.
It's not really the Man City result that you should be worried about, is it? It's the result against Everton and Brentford. Both games, you know, you didn't deserve to win.
100%. I don't think we deserved to win yesterday. I think if the truth being, I didn't think there was too much of a difference in the two teams. I thought slightly we was the better team in the first half, second half, Man City without a doubt. But yes, it's the Everton game. That's the game. That is the game. When you look at it, all eyes are on us for that game. I said on the thing that most teams would have lost to Everton this season after that game, but I think Manchester City wouldn't have. You know, and I think that you have to look at a couple of things, which is a bit of a worry for me from Arsenal's point of view. Manchester City lose to Tottenham, they go and win their next game. Manchester United draw to Leeds, drop 2 points, then they win and won their next game. Arsenal haven't done that. They've gone to Everton, slipped up. The Brentford game, then they should come back and win that game, and didn't perform. And that was the thing. Being really honest, I don't think we was that great yesterday neither. We didn't play as well as what we can. Too many players off. And the biggest worry for me now, and it is a worry, is players like Xhaka couldn't finish the game yesterday. Looked tired, looked jaded, like, you know. So squad rotation is something that we've got to do now.
Buvey, will Arsenal make top four?
They'll definitely come fourth. They'll definitely come fourth. They've had a fantastic season. Well, actually, based on last season, they were 9 points clear in fourth and they came fifth and they bottled that. So who knows? Like, all I'm going to say is Arsenal are the best looking side in the Premier League. And they were with Samir Nasri, Van Persie back in the day. And they never won the league with that squad either. There's a difference between being the best side in the league and winning the Premier League. There is a big difference. And City, we didn't look good yesterday. Pep came out and said he hated the formation. He was experimenting. He was messing around with it.
When's he going to stop? Is he bored? Is that what it is?
He's trying to find a way of overloading the midfield. So if you notice yesterday, when Arsenal had the ball, their centre-backs were pressed by four people. It was Haaland, De Bruyne, Gundogan, and one of Grealish or Mahrez, depending on where the ball was on the pitch. If you break that press, you've only got Rodri left. But if you don't break that press, like we saw with Arsenal, with some of their shocking passing from Ramsdale, Saliba, then they get a load of pressure on them. I think Arsenal, I compare this Arsenal side to maybe the Liverpool side that were competing with City to win the Premier League with 97-point, 98-point season. They're nowhere near that side. They're nowhere near that side. They got a soft underbelly, a lack of leadership. When things were going rough, you're looking for your centre-backs to be tough, to be rugged. They got absolutely bullied by Erling Haaland. It's Didier Drogba all over again. Didier Drogba used to go to Arsenal year in, year out, what, for 8-9 years? And he bullied Arsenal for a laugh with his mates in the WhatsApp group. Now Haaland's going there in Norwegian and doing exactly the same. He absolutely he made Saliba look championship yesterday. I bullied him. Maybe not the cleanest performance, but I bullied him physically.
I love your definitive statements, Buvey, right? I get it. Like, but I don't think Saliba looked championship level. Arsenal were good and matched City up most of the first half. It came on a little bit on top in the second half. You could argue about the lack of depth in Arsenal's squad. Very young team as well. Naive, maybe.
Flav, naivety. Like, you know, we didn't get bullied by Haaland yesterday. Played into his hands. What we'd done yesterday was like, and this is on Arteta yesterday. We like to play out from the back. So to play out from the back, you have to take risk. And another thing you do, which is what's been told as a defender and everything, don't let the ball bounce. But the reason Arsenal were letting the ball bounce is so that they can get on the foot and play. You've got to respect your opponent. Haaland, like yesterday, that is his game, getting there and all that. Don't give him that opportunity. And we give him that opportunity because of the lack of respect, I think, from Arteta towards that there. I looked at Pep yesterday and I don't care. He looked at Arsenal and thought, right, how can I nullify him? How can I do this and do that? And mate, and that's what he done. Arteta just went out there and thought, oh, do you know what? We can play like this and do that. Naive. You don't do that again. You don't give Haaland. I've watched Haaland against Tottenham. He never got a kick because Tottenham didn't let him bully him by playing. They just played over the press. And Arsenal today, as Buvey made a great point there, they said, play over the press sometimes. Just go long. We try to play out all the time, naive, and top teams find you out.
Well, I just say like we found playing City pretty easy. I thought they looked quite ordinary. I don't know what it is that
the biggest game of your season every year. We're not talking about Spurs. It's the biggest trophy you win every year is beating Man City trophy.
We're not talking about Spurs. I'm talking about
congrats on winning the beating Man City trophy, mate. Congratulations, Flav.
Why are you so easily rattled, Buvey? Why?
Not rattled. You're going to make a DVD about beating us last week. Congratulations, mate.
I'm just saying it's one of the most comfortable games we had this season. Adam. I've got two questions for you. Firstly, where do you genuinely think Arsenal will finish? Can they still win the league? Are they going to fall apart? Firstly,
I've always had this feeling that City would eventually come not good, because I don't want it to happen, but come out on top. I just think the lack of experience from Arsenal would show. I think the lack of depth in the squad would show. I didn't expect the flip to happen so soon. I know City have played more games, but I didn't expect this already. So maybe that's happened quicker than I expected. But in the game, I think Lee's right. Arsenal were naive. I think they played into City's hands in the second half a little bit. I thought the first half was pretty even. But I thought that was Erling Haaland's best game in a Man City shirt. I know he scored 3 and 4 in a game and all that kind of stuff. But even without the goal yesterday, he led that line really well. Saliba played well, I thought, and still kind of got given the runaround by Erling Haaland. That's how good he was. So Arsenal could finish third. They could finish fourth. I don't think they'll finish outside of the top Champions League spots. And you'd probably expect them to finish second. But the thing with Arsenal is, and it's something we said last season, they're very emotional. So when things are going really well, you know, everything's up here and, you know, the fans are buzzing at the Emirates and everyone's behind them and, you know, they look unbeatable. But when there is cracks showing, or when there are cracks showing and they take a defeat, like Lee said, bouncing back straight away, have they done it against Brentford? No. They then go and follow it up against City with another defeat. They're very emotional. They remind me of United under Solskjaer. When you're winning, everything's flying and that, and then you just take this knock and it rocks you and you find it hard to recover. And I think the lack of squad depth isn't helping. Yeah,
just on that quickly, Lee, what's the mood like in the Arsenal fan base at the moment? Like, they're being philosophical. They realise it's just
you know, it's a long season. Arteta himself said the title race is a marathon, right? So are they being philosophical or knee-jerky? What's the mood?
I think that, you know, Adam makes a great point there, like, you know, and there is that worry, I think, that, you know, like, the bounce back thing of it all there, like the squad depth is one thing. Like, I think, listen, Arsenal fans at this moment, so I can only speak for myself, can't speak for other Arsenal fans. I'm proud of the team, the way we've been playing, the way we are, what we've been doing. That game yesterday is something that I've been dying for a very, very long time. First versus second, and we're involved, and we're still involved in it. But when you look at it, you cannot go into a game like Manchester City without your best two players. You know that we've now playing 6, 7, 8, 9 games without Jesus. He's a massive, massive loss for us. Over a course of a season, one or two games you can, but not over that course. If Haaland was to, I love it if we go to the Etihad and Haaland's not playing and Rodri. You know what I mean? Like,
still beat you. Still beat you, unfortunately.
But yeah, but, they might well do. But I think that we'd stand a better chance. But the fact is, you can't take on Manchester City without your two best players. That is a fact. So that's something that we can take a little bit of comfort from. But I think the Arsenal fans at this moment in time are not too worried. Look, I've always said if we come second, we were up against a machine that. The players that they've got, the squad rotation that they've got, you know, and they've got a manager or a coach or whatever you call him that knows what it takes to win trophies, knows what it takes, and the fans know it as well. I tell you what, I've spoken to a couple of Man City fans before and after the game. They knew what was coming. They expected Manchester City to win that game because they've been there before and everything like that. So. Arsenal, it's been a long time since we've been like that. But I will say this, look, we have been in title races before and it's not over yet. It is not over yet. We've got to get Jesus back and Partey back as soon as possible and we've got to get back on the run. But, you know, I will get more and more worried as it goes. We have got to beat Villa, but that's going to be a difficult game at this good moment side. In time. You know?
So, I really don't see that, you know.
I'm with you on that, Adam. I can easily see us losing that game or dropping more points. And, you know, the fact of the matter is, if Manchester City are not going to lose 3 or 4 games on the bounce or not win for 3 or 4 games, that's the difference. You know, Arsenal have got to get that mentality right. And that starts with the manager. You know what I mean? Yesterday, making a ridiculous decision in my eyes. You know what I mean? Ben White's been our best defender, been our best best English defender in the whole Premier League this season. The biggest game, he drops him.
Why is that? Is that injury, mate? Why is that out of interest?
I honestly don't know. He was on the bench.
Tommy Yasu made a mistake as well, didn't he? Led to a goal.
Yeah, you know.
He's a good player, though, Tommy Yasu.
He played Tommy Yasu against Liverpool, though, didn't he?
Yeah, he played left back there, Adam, and changed it a little bit. I just think at the end of it, you know, you look at yesterday and... I'm going to be really honest about it. You know, I'm disappointed with McKola because on the basis of we are where we are with that 11 and you've got Manchester City, take that 11 out there and go and prove it, like, you know, but it wasn't to be, like, you know, and I think, like...
I do think that's part of the problem, though, you know, Lee, that your 11 kind of picks itself every single week and that's a good thing at times because it breeds continuity in that. But then at other times, if Martinelli knows he's starting every week... That little bit of zip in training is going to come out of him, and you know you need competition. And unfortunately, City have got it in every.
Yeah, they've got it.
Even Haaland's got it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, Pep Guardiola is not going to be surprised by Arsenal's tactic. He'll know how to deal with it because they play the same way every week. But why should they change? Because they've been absolutely.
The only way City don't win the league is if Pep tries weird things.
He's winding me up.
The only way he can lose it is throwing it away.
We tried a weird thing against Villa and we tried it against Arsenal. We picked up 3 points and
Spurs. You're starting like
admittedly so. He does mess up sometimes.
Yeah, I mean, as soon as I saw the starting lineup against Tottenham, I thought we're gonna win today. And that's
against Spurs is an anomaly. We can't use that as serious analysis.
It's not an anomaly.
It is an anomony.
We controlled the entire game.
It happens every year, though.
You never scored a goal at Tottenham. Never scored one. Not one goal.
Enjoy that. Let's build the whole episode around that then. Congratulations. But the only thing I'd say is that...
Can I just say one thing? Which is...
Buvey, we'll come to you after.
just one thing was a positive for Arsenal yesterday, and when we went 1-0 down yesterday, the response from them from that was very, very positive. I know I've just said a few negatives, but I thought our response from that was very, very good, you know. So from that point of view, that does give me as a fan a little bit of hope going forward.
Okay. Buvey, in your preview to the game, you said, mark my words, if City arrive at the Emirates in the right way, we will beat Arsenal. What was it that you was, what made you so confident?
I think we've got 6 or 7 world-class players. I think Ruben Diaz, world-class, Rodri, Bernardo Silva, De Bruyne, Haaland. I don't see Arsenal having that same quality. Now, they've been had that quality in terms of form for the last six or nine months. You could argue Odegaard's been maybe the best player in the whole league. He's been that good. I think what Lee said about Ben White is fair. Maybe not as good as John Stones, but he's been at least number two English defender in the league easily. Saliba, unbelievable this season. You stretch out across 3 or 4 years, we're talking about Saliba being on loan in a Farmers League. We're talking about Ben White struggled when he first joined. Tomiyasu is not a world-class fullback. Again, I'm not sitting here trying to on Arsenal because I know that things change in football and eventually Arsenal will win something. They are that good. We can't forget how young this squad is. And if we're talking about, in this video, we're talking about can Arsenal win the Premier League this season? I don't see they've got enough quality. Eddie Nketiah, I think Lee made a good point. When you knock it long to Eddie Nketiah, it will be that for the next few weeks at least. Is he gonna hold the ball? Is he gonna be aggressive? And he's not that kind of guy. I mean, I saw Arsenal fans calling him Francis Jeffers 2.0, and he is a finisher. He's a good finisher. But then you convert it around. All right, so he's not gonna hold the ball up. He hasn't got the physicality. He's not a Didier Drogba type. He's not a Haaland. Give him 3 chances in the box. He didn't hit the target once last night. Exactly. Right. So, and that's not good enough. So, you know, maybe Arsenal fans are happy with top four. Absolutely. They need to be a Champions League club. They have to be a Champions League club. But if we talk about it in the paradigm of being a Premier League title race, they aren't good enough, in my opinion.
That's a great point. He makes a great point there about Eddie. You know, I think that if you're not going to score goals, you have to bring something else to the party, like, you know, and he hasn't got that. And so he's a goal scorer. So when you get chances that he gets in that game. Listen, the different, you know, if Haaland played for Arsenal win that game yesterday, like, you know, because the chances that we created for Eddie, they're food and drink to somebody like Haaland, you know, and that's what it comes down to, you know. And we are missing Jesus when you look at it from that point of view. But I feel for Eddie because as soon as he misses a chance, everybody thinks, oh, he's not good enough. But the fact of the matter is, he's a backup striker. He isn't our main striker, but he is at this moment in time. And Arsenal will have to take a little bit of a blame for that, boys, because in January, you know, Jesus went down in, was it the 4th of December at 7:30 p.m., I think it was. Like, you know what I mean? That's how bad it was for us. You know what I mean? I knew it was going to be a bad, bad day. But we had a chance to do something in January. We chose not to.
The problem, you would be hamstrung, though, wouldn't you? Because he's on 100 grand a week. Like, as a backup striker, you're not going to bring another striker on 100 grand a week just because Eddie Nketiah is not going to play.
Yeah, exactly, you know what I mean? But, you know, do you need more than one striker? I said a thing yesterday, a little bit of snobbery for Arsenal fans is Manchester United went out and got the Dutch fella. You know, well, we don't need him. Like, but sometimes you do. Sometimes you need to go out.
Trust me,
no, we don't need him.
One in 10 for Burnley.
Yeah,
how many goals your striker scored in semi-finals this season, you mug? That's what I thought as well.
Look, he may not be world class, but he is an option, and that's what an Eddie Nketiah last night was.
Exactly. We needed, you know, a little bit more. And the thing with it, do you know what? I'm going to say this now, Eddie. He's a decent player, like, you know, but he's not got blistering pace. He holds the ball up, but he doesn't hold it up exceptionally well, like, you know. Or he works hard, you know what I mean? But he's just not that level that you need to be to go for titles. But that's not his fault because he is what he is. He's a backup striker, like, you know, unfortunate.
And it's only going to get more difficult for Arsenal and their sort of limited squad.
Well, I think he's got to change it, Flav. I think it's now come Villa.
It's Villa, but there's also the Europa League coming. A lot of games coming. It's going to be difficult for Arsenal. But
I found it weird that he signed Trossard and did it. I thought Trossard was a good signing, but then to not change things up a little bit, rotate a little bit, was a bit weird.
Adam,
especially after he scored a crucial goal.
Adam, what I don't like is this sort of United are not in the title race talk.
No, we're not.
Well, you are.
We're just trying to cement safety.
What, can you not finish above Arsenal? You mean safety in the top four?
Once we get, we've got 40 points now, so I think safety's in the bag. Now it's about
it is embarrassing for a club spot
sewn up. Once that's sewn up, we'll try and get Europa League sewn up.
He's doing my trick. It's embarrassing. He's copying me. It's embarrassing.
Just keep building from there. Really, what
sewing things up.
We're not in a title race. Like I said, we've just taken a striker on loan from Burnley. You know what I mean?
Man United have spent £1 billion in the last 6 years. They've won one League Cup against Southampton, and they're bringing their side down like this.
Mate, you lot are going down with £1 billion in the bank. So
let's not have a day off. This is a football podcast, not a law podcast. Talking about football. Yeah, you spent £1 billion in 6 years.
We'll talk about law when you're in the Championship.
You spent £1 billion in 6 years. You can't even compete for the Premier Mugs, titles.
Adam, Championship you, don't even want.
Man United have seemingly gone without.
Back to the days of Paul Dickhoff.
Man United have gone under the radar with this spending stuff. That, like, how you've got the squad you have, having spent the
money.
Excuse me a minute.
I was about to call you Trev then. Excuse me a minute, Trev. What the hell are you talking about? You's like won the transfer window. You're not allowed to talk about the transfers.
You're not allowed to talk about transfers. I'm just a host. I'm a conduit for conversation.
No.
A minute ago, you were slagging off City about Spurs beating us and all that. Now you're a host. Are you making a DVD or not?
Arsenal are in the mud, but let's switch this on Spurs.
I've made
it. Yeah, Flav.
I've made
in the Champions League.
I appreciate your comments.
Losing Boogie. Against AC Milan, who haven't won a game all season.
I appreciate
Diaz,
your comments.
Brahim Diaz.
All right, I won't.
From this point onwards, Brahim Diaz.
From this point onwards, I'm the host, and I just want to say, Ad, I just want to. It needs to be said. You spent so much money, and Man United fans keep moaning about how they've not got no depth in their squad. How are
we
you in
got
a position?
Depth in our squad. You know how
is that possible?
We're about 7-8 players left on frees. Cavani, Lingard, Mata, Pogba, Matic. Like, a lot of players left on frees. So once they left, we needed to replace them. You replaced them by spending money. We spent money. We bought in about 5 players. So we're still down a couple. Do you know what I mean? Poor. The squad's not complete
yet. Terrible.
And if you look at Anthony, we've been relying on Anthony Martial, who's out on loan to Sevilla last season. As much as I love him, you know what I mean? But you can't rely on him, he's made of Weetabix.
Good enough.
Now we got Wout Weghorst running about. So we're third, yeah, with that. Imagine when Erik ten Hag gets the guys that he wants.
He got the guy, he got a Beyblade for £100 million. He got a Beyblade for £100 million. He's been absolutely shocking.
Scored more goals than Jack Grealish.
Yeah, and Jack Grealish scored a goal against the
best side in Watford. If we're going to talk about the amount of goals and stuff, you know, 100 million down the drain.
Jack Grealish won a Premier League title. He's won more Premier Leagues in the last 1 year than you have in 10 years.
None of them are going to count in about a year, though, are they?
You know what's funny, yeah? Out of all the times that someone's finished above City, yeah, they'll get the league like United in, you know, 11, 12 and all that. One time Spurs finished above him, City finished third.
Yeah. Do you know the only thing we're going to do?
You can't even get an imaginary, like...
No, listen.
Man
United are going to get 3 titles. Liverpool are going to get 3 titles. Spurs are going to get a Carabao Cup. That's the reality. That's not even a joke.
You don't even get an FA Cup.
What do you mean? No, no. Well, we played you. You beat us a couple of years ago. Do you remember?
It was 2019, wasn't it?
What, does that not count?
Oh, it's up to 2018, I think.
It's still cheated at that point, isn't it? It's still cheating. You cheated.
Is this a law podcast? What is this, a law podcast?
Okay, all right.
Why am I invited onto this podcast?
let's round it up. Law. Let's round it up. Boovy, where will Manchester City finish and where will Arsenal finish?
I think Arsenal guaranteed top four now. Guaranteed top four. Champions League football for the first time in what, 8-9 years, is it? Or maybe 7 years. Fantastic for them. Congratulations. City are going to go on to win 3 Premier Leagues in 3. We're talking 5 in 6 years. That's how good it is for City. I think we're coming to our own. We've got world-class experience and we've got the best manager in world football. We're going to win the league.
That's what happens when you're financially doped. And Ad...
Yeah.
Where are City going to finish? Where are Arsenal going to finish?
I think City win the league. Arsenal finish second or third.
Okay. And how about you, Lee?
I'm gonna say we keep on the coattails of Man City. Anything can happen, but I just think Man City.
You're not on the coattails. You got a game in hand.
We got a game in hand. Yeah, but like, you know, and also
you're 8 points clear.
That could be winning.
2 weeks ago, we were a title race and they've already bottled it.
Man, we've never been eight points clear, like, you know, with that, at the end of it, you know, there's always these games coming up. There's tricky games coming up. Look, listen, we're still in with a chance, but I've always said that we're probably...
Where's your Arsenal hat today, by the way, Lee?
Yeah, where's your track
Where's your Arsenal hat? Your Arsenal
I only wear it. I only wear it when we win.
I've never seen you with North Face and Jordan on before.
Yeah.
Right, you know, I only back winners. You know what I mean? I only back winners.
Yes, we Buvey said embarrassing again. Every single episode. I mean, everything you do, it's embarrassment. You're naive. Grow up.
Not in real life. Not on a law podcast like I've been invited on with you, apparently.
All right, let's leave it there. Let's find out who this week's last fan standing is. Scores at the end of the show this week, and our last man standing is Buvey with 9 points. Love these congratulations to Flav for winning the beating Manchester City.
You congratulated him on winning the league last season, last week.
Didn't.
Congratulations on winning the Premier League. Do you remember that last week?
Yeah, a couple of weeks ago, he definitely said that.
Yeah, he's been saying it every week.
If you haven't got the evidence, don't make claims.
God, it's spoken like a true man.
Please, whoever's editing this, have the evidence.
Lee has 8 points. Lee has 8. Great comments on Arsenal's naive tactics against Manchester City. And Adam, coming up the rear, we have great comments on emotional Arsenal side. You're coming up the rear. Come on, grow up.
Good times.
Arsenal were never going to win the league, let's be completely real. They had a soft underbelly against Man City. Erling Haaland got on a coach, got on a megabus down to North London. He took the pocket money of Arsenal's backline easy. He bullied them all night. Didier Drogba for the last 8 years at Chelsea. That's what Erling Haaland did against Arsenal. They haven't got the experience. They haven't got the power. They haven't got the leadership. They bottled it. They fell apart last night. There's no question about it. So for me, Arsenal... there was never a chance they were going to win the league with such a soft manager like Arteta at the helm.
That's it for Last Fan Standing. Congratulations to Buvey. Let us know in the comments below. Will Arsenal go on to win this? Are they soft? Are they naive? What's going on at Arsenal? So let us know in the comments below what you think about what's happened at the Emirates. And will City go on to win the league? If you're still here and you enjoy what we're doing, click like and subscribe. And we'll see you next week.